listeners of Adelaide Place. I want to take a few moments of your time to draw your attention to some of our plans for phased return to a restricted gathering in our physical building of Adelaide Place. And I also want to take a few moments to give you a sense of why we as a leadership team feel that this is the right thing for us to be considering in light of the recent changes of the government's guidelines for churches and communities of faith. So let me first of all start with giving you a sense of some of the why we think this is important. Having a presence for us as a church in the city centre has been important for us over a number of years for this community that normally meets here. But it hasn't always been easy. There's been many a season where we as a church could have felt, wouldn't it have been easier if we could move to the suburbs, or if we could, maybe if the parking was cheaper or free. But there's always been that sense that though it may be costly to us, it's significant that God has placed us here in the city centre of Glasgow, that there's a presence of a worshiping community. And we as a leadership team have the sense of, though it may in this season be costly in a different way of our time, our energy, our travel, we now might need to get dressed to come to church. We feel this is another chapter in the life of our community where we choose to be present in the place that God has called us and rooted us in the city centre of Glasgow. As well as that, we love that there's the chance for us to be present to our local place and offer hospitality again from where we are in the city centre of Glasgow. And thirdly and finally, as well as the chance to be, this will give us a chance to be together and welcome each other, it's another and a new opportunity for a shared experience of worship on a Sunday, which for many over the last number of months has just been missing completely. So that's why there's a sense that it's a costly presence, it's an opportunity to show hospitality and welcome, and it's also an opportunity, a new opportunity for some sort of a shared experience in worship on a Sunday which has been missing. So what will that look like? Well, let me just give you some of the headlines with a promise of more details and a video of a lot of details to follow to leave you with all the information that you need. Well, first of all, the main idea I want you to understand is that our online gatherings will continue as they are in the present format on the live premiere that you get every Sunday. We don't want anybody to feel obliged to come immediately to some of these new gatherings that we are going to be begin and propose. And in particular, if you're shielding, we want you to feel to come only when it feels right and ready and safe for you. And also, it should probably go without saying that if you have any symptoms at all, or if you're self-isolating, then we would ask you not to come at all. Okay, so the gatherings will be intentionally aligned as closely as possible to our online gatherings to give us a sense of togetherness and shared experience that we're after. So, as I said, a more detailed video will come explain exactly, but here's some of the details I'd love you just to know of what we are proposing. It'll be a limited gathering of up to 50 people, one at 11 a.m. and one at 8 p.m. It'll be the same service with distinct teams and distinct communities that will meet there. It will be hosted by our real live person. We will have physical distancing measures in place and all the measures that we need to comply with the government's guidelines. We've done a rigorous risk assessment based on the guidelines from the Baptist Union of Scotland and the government's guidelines, and we'll continue to do a risk assessment on an ongoing basis. The music will more than likely be live, but it also may be the same music that you see on our normal online gathering. When it is live, it will be a band, a leader, with one person singing behind the screen, and there will be no corporate singing, and everybody that's in attendance will be wearing a face mask. Unless there's medical reasons why that's not the case, and that will be how we'll express that part of our worship. The sermon will be on the screen as per YouTube, so it'll be the same sermon beamed onto our rather large screen in the auditorium, and the prayers, the scripture at this gathering will be live in the place. We will use a one-way system, and there will encourage lots of smiling with our eyes and with above the face mask, and we would encourage people not to hang around, and so stewards will lead people out of the building row by row to ensure there's no unnecessary mingling after and before a gathering. There will be many more questions and details, particularly when it comes to how do we sign up, because we will have a process for that. It's already in place and it'll involve track and tracing to allow that capacity to be there. But for now, we are moving towards launching on September the 13th as the Sunday where we'll begin an 11 a.m. and an 8 p.m. gathering at Adelaide Place, 209 Bath Street. It'll be exactly the same gathering, and we really are looking forward to welcome you soon to those. A final note to some of you who may be hesitant to sign up, either because you don't want other people to miss out on an opportunity, or you might still just not feel ready yet. Please, if you're up for coming to these gatherings, just sign up and don't be reluctant to do so. If there's too much demand and we're struggling to find space, please leave us with that problem to figure out how to build capacity and give people a fair chance. But please don't be reluctant to sign up just out of trying to look out for other people. Please join with us in prayer and reflection and when you can on a Sunday. We are genuinely really looking forward to safely welcoming you to our gathering soon on September the 13th. If you have any more questions, please get in touch. But do know that in the meantime, there will be videos coming out just to give you more details on the precise sign up and what you can expect on a Sunday at church. Thanks for listening to this.